the things he does. I can't really say I hate anybody. I could take that back and say that I hate the way he acts, and I hate the way he is. I don't hate him.
We'll show you the ropes, eh?
Yeah. My mom lives in Wareham. They got divorced when I was little. But can't live with her either. She doesn't want me, so here I am. They're not letting me smoke my dope. They're making me wait. It's horrible.
The fact that she's a runaway, busted with marijuana, wouldn't be good. You'd have to go back to what, lockup?
Yeah, I'm going to lockup anyways if I get caught.
Yeah, but it'd be even worse.
Yeah, I just got to make it to 18.
We're definitely going to the Hobo Convention in Iowa. On a westbound train, it should only take us a day.
Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby. You dare to dream, maybe do come true.
We thought we were going west, but we think we went south. We might be going to Kansas.
Just past Hopkinsville on the map, just outside of Nashville.
Is that where we want to be?
No.
How long have we been on this train?
Roughly 12 hours.
In the wrong direction?
Yeah.
It's pretty hard to go the wrong direction in Canada when there's only east and west to go. You have to be pretty fucking drunk to go.
I was almost back. I was like this close.
No, you weren't.
Well, I was already halfway from Massachusetts.
You're still halfway, just further south. You had to go south anyway to get there.
But we're going back north. We're just going to backtrack and go back up. We'll get there. We'll get to Iowa.
Think we'll get there in time for the Hobo Convention?
We're stuck in the middle of open countryside. It's a long way to the next train yard before we can get off. We're way off course, yet somehow we don't mind.
I've been drifting along in the same stay old shoes, loose ends, tie the noose in the back of my mind. If you thought that you were making your way to where the puzzles and pagans lay, I put it together, it's a strange invitation.
Wendy's told me about the drift, a carefree state of mind that overtakes you on the train. I'm losing all sense of time and place. My life in London seems far, far away.
When I wake up, someone will sweep up my lazy bones. And we will rise in the cool of the evening. I remember the way that you smiled when the gravity shackles were wild. There's something is vacant when I think it's all beginning.
Tennessee under a bridge.
So we're sitting there in the heat trying to decide what to do. This guy appears out of nowhere.
What's your name again?
Travis.
Travis.
Nice to meet you. Lindsay, how old is everybody?
Guys,
guess.
Yeah, you gotta guess.
16.
17. Come on.
18. 16.
Huh?
How old? 25.
25? Yeah.
So you left your stuff down here, and you went to work, and then you came back to get your stuff, is that right?
Yeah, well, the job sucks.
I just recently was in California. I went to Los Angeles first, and then stayed in Hollywood, did a little bit of acting, modeling. I've been riding trains for about 3 years. My name was Rails. Hell, I'll come with you, I guess. I don't know. I mean, really, there isn't really much.
It's nice
to
be free because you can just go whenever you want.
Travis is a bullshit artist who wandered out of the bushes. He'd been sleeping on rooftops and working as a waiter during the day. He's ready to get out of Nashville.
It's nice. He's a lot of common with me. That's weird. Like, everything he said, I did. He had in common with me. Like, everything I could relate to.
You probably find a lot of people who have a lot in common with you when you're traveling.
Yeah.
Wendy, Todd, and I are feeling somewhat skeptical about our new friend.
What do you think?
I couldn't get on that.
Is it slowing down? Come back. We're gonna go on the other side of that train, and we're gonna walk behind it so the tower can't see us, and we're gonna walk all the way to the bridge, and then we'll cross back over.
What the hell's going on? None of the trains seem to be stopping. Once again, we rely on the workers. It's cool that they keep up the tradition of helping hobos. Wendy discovers we're in the wrong yard altogether.
Nothing from here going west. He says for sure going to that other yard and there's lots going to Memphis. I asked him what time crew changes were and he's just like all the time.
Sixteen hours after arriving in Nashville, we finally pulled out on another train.
Travis and Lindsay are about 5 cars up in a boxcar. We had a little chat with them last night because we're not feeling very comfortable traveling with them. Travis seems to think he knows everything there is to know about riding trains, but his behavior so far has demonstrated that he's pretty careless.
I got. Oh, you can't do it on there.
Hey, you set up here?
Yeah, every time we go by a crossing and we see a car, we get on it, we point the gun and go bang.
You know, you might get us kicked off if you do that. You should really hide when you go through the crossing.
And make sure we do it in the country where nobody knows.
Okay.
I don't want to see your bodies fucking fly by.
If the train stops suddenly, you might just go bang into the ditch.
60 miles an hour.
After their night together in the boxcar, Lindsay is feeling freaked out by Travis.
A little too fast, I guess.